It's happening, folks. It's finally happening. A little over 18 months since Insomniac left us all with that tremendous tease of Venom at the end of 2018's Spider-Man PS4, leaks and rumors surrounding a sequel are finally starting to do the rounds. They're all pointing to something particularly special, though given just how good the first game was, that should really go without saying, especially with the power of the PlayStation 5 now at Insomniac's disposal. So, from possible villains to major gameplay changes and possible settings, I'm Ewan from What Culture Gaming, and here's every leak and rumor regarding Spider-Man 2 fans need to know. Spoilers for the first game ahead as well, you've been warned. Number 14. Yes, it'll release on PlayStation 5. Let's get the obvious one out of the way first. Given that next-gen consoles are due to release by the end of 2020, at least at the time of recording, there's no way that Insomniac's Spider-Man sequel won't be heading to the PlayStation 5. And that's obviously good news. Yes, Sony managed to bore everyone to tears the other week with their PS5 quote-unquote reveal, but so far, all indications from actual video game developers is that it's shaping up to be a really exciting console. Number 13. It'll release sometime in 2021. Release windows will no doubt continue to be more precarious as the year progresses, but currently, rumors point towards Insomniac's Spider-Man sequel releasing sometime in 2021. Given literally every video game ends up releasing in the last 3 months of the year, one would expect Spider-Man 2 to drop around the September to December mark, just like the first did. Number 12. It'll be set during winter. Forget the possibility of multiple playable protagonists, new villains, and abilities. By far the most exciting revelation from the recent spate of rumors and leaks has been that Spider-Man 2 will be set 5 to 6 months after the first, during winter. It looks as though Insomniac are taking a leaf out of Sony Animation's book on this one, with 2018's literally the best comic movie ever, what do you mean it's not, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, doing wonders with its Christmas time version of New York. There's also the fact that Spidey has a proven track record of rocking some tremendous winter looks, adorning his usual red and blue getup with scarves, beanies, earmuffs, and leg warmers to stay warm. Number 11. Brooklyn and Queens will be included. So, winter is a great change of setting for the sequel to have, but you know what's even cooler? The fact that Spider-Man 2 may include Brooklyn and Queens as additional locations in the open world. Before Spider-Man PS4 came around, pretty much everyone's favorite Spider-Man game was Treyarch's movie tie-in for 2004's Spider-Man 2. However, for my money's worth, the following year's Ultimate Spider-Man was definitely superior, one of the reasons why being that it expanded the previous game's hub world of Manhattan and let players explore Queens as a teenage Peter Parker. According to rumors though, Insomniac's next Spider-Man game may even do one better by including Manhattan, Brooklyn, and Queens. Mercy me. Number 10. Peter and MJ are living together. Although the last game's story started off with Peter and MJ consciously uncoupled, they ended it by rekindling their relationship. It seems as though they've come along even further by the time the sequel picks up their story though, with rumors stating that they've now moved in with each other. Fans will recall how the last game ended, with MJ suggesting Peter could stop at her place anytime he liked, wink wink nudge nudge, but he ended up moving into a new apartment of his own. Whether he's done out his current place or he's just moved into MJ's flat is currently unknown, but I think I speak for all Spidey fans when I ominously chant, kiss, kiss, kiss. Number 9. Yes, Venom is definitely going to appear. Back to the bombshell ending of the first game now, that being the revelation that Harry Osborn, friend to Peter and MJ and the son of Norman Osborn, hadn't actually left the country and was instead being held in isolation at his father's secret lab. Fans quickly gathered that the black goop attached to Harry was none other than the Venom symbiote, and while the character has never worn the symbiote in mainstream Marvel continuity, this isn't actually the first time he's done so in related media. Between this tease and the absence of the symbiote suit from the first game's skins, Insomniac seemed poised to deliver their own reimagining of the famous black costume saga from the comics, a sentiment echoed in the recent leaks and rumors. Number 8. Norman Osborn is trying to create new super soldiers. Seemingly not content with inviting a private army into NYC or with bonding an alien creature to his own child, it seems as though Norman Osborn will be up to plenty in the next Spider-Man game. One rumor posits that the Green Goblin will appear, while another, more recent leak, states that Osborn is busy trying to create new super soldiers. Juicier still is that the rumor suggests he'll be utilizing cloning technology to make it happen, although whose DNA it'll come from is still unclear. Also important to note is how the super soldier angle gives Insomniac the perfect perfect entry point to depict Norman's transformation into the Green Goblin, with most interpretations of the character utilizing some form of serum to enhance their strength, albeit at the slight cost of their own sanity. Number 7. The Marvel Gamerverse takes shape. One of the most exciting things about booting up and playing the last game for the first time was discovering just how integrated it was into the wider Marvel universe. Insomniac went to great lengths to make everything feel connected, including a truckload of brilliant Easter eggs that reference the likes of the Avengers, Daredevil, and even Doctor Strange. Now, if rumors are to be believed, it looks as though they'll be taking things a step further in the sequel. The leaks from January said that Insomniac will, quote, hint towards a bigger Marvel universe, and one would assume those hints will be more explicit this time around. Marvel has stated that both the upcoming Avengers game from Square Enix and Spider-Man PS4 are part of the same quote-unquote gamerverse, and with all the talk of super soldiers and cloning, Spider-Man commenting that the Avengers are on the West Coast in the last game, and Steve Rogers dying too, might it be possible that Osborn is using Captain America's DNA for his own schemes? Number 6. Eddie Brock will have a major role. Eddie Brock may not have made a physical appearance in Insomniac's first Spider-Man game, but he still managed to nab a cameo in the form of a Leavers card gifted to Peter when he left the Daily Bugle. Even though we don't know what Brock could be up to in the sequel, the most recent leaks have stated that he'll have a major role to play in the story. With Venom lurking around, that seems like a given, but seeing as how it's currently attached to Harry, it's clear Insomniac aren't looking to retread familiar ground. Will Brock be a rival to Mary Jane at the Daily Bugle? Might it be possible he takes on a different symbiote? Only time will tell. As a side, the January leaks also pointed out that joining Brock in a supporting role will be Ben Urich, Flash Thompson, and Aaron Davis. Number 5. Carnage and Mysterio will also feature. Fans already assumed that Venom would play a key role in the sequel, but the most recent leaks have gone and done one better. If they are to be believed, then it looks as though Carnage will also make an appearance in Spider-Man 2. One would imagine that they too would play an important part if Venom is around, given they're technically related. But again, it's too early to tell at this stage. It's also too early to tell whether or not it will be Cletus Kasady underneath the red and black symbiote, even if it's likely that he'll be in the picture somewhere. Also exciting to note is that Mysterio will supposedly feature in the game too. Quentin Beck is on the rise after his brilliant appearance in Spider-Man Far From Home, so his inclusion in the next game should be a dead cert. Number 4. Free roam Miles Morales might be a possibility. For all that new villains and settings are great though, possibly the biggest question on everyone's minds following the first game was, will we get to play as Miles Morales as Spider-Man? The answer is still forthcoming, but following the end of the first game and the DLC that followed, it seems like it's only a matter of when, not if, players will get to suit up in Miles' now iconic black and red costume. The rumors so far seem to corroborate that speculation. Miles will ostensibly boast a different fighting style to Peter, and will be able to utilize his own unique powers in combat. One would assume these would be his Venom Blasts and his ability to turn invisible. Further still, the most recent leaks point towards Insomniac modeling their system for players taking control of Miles and Peter on Arkham Knight's dual play mechanic, where players could play as both Batman and a designated ally in a given area. The most recent leaks also state how Insomniac are supposedly unsure of whether or not to make Miles' Spidey playable in free roam. Here's hoping they do decide to make him playable that way though, and for the game to adopt a similar system to that of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, where players could take control of Jacob or Evie Fry whenever they wanted. Number 3. Random crimes are getting an overhaul. For all that the random crimes in Spider-Man PS4 were appreciated, they did start to get repetitive over time. Thankfully, it seems as though Insomniac have noticed this, as leaks have stated that random crimes will be getting an overhaul this time around. Although early in development, the studio are apparently working on a Diablo-esque dungeons mechanic, whereby randomized crimes will be spawned into the world and generate different situations for the player to deal with. The example used in the earlier leak describes how, in the event of a bank robbery, enemies won't be placed in the same area and players will be faced with evolving mini-objectives as they play. Number 2. And so will the web-slinging. There was so much Insomniac's last Spider-Man game got right, and one of them was definitely the swinging. Zipping across Manhattan felt speedy and exciting, which is why it may surprise some readers to hear that the studio are planning some changes to swinging in the next title. One such change will supposedly come in the form of web zipping. In the next game, players will be able to chain zips together into one smooth motion, making it easier to traverse the skyscraperless Queens, for instance. Insomniac will apparently include 3 different versions of web-slinging as well. They are being described currently as realistic, modeled in the vein of 2004's Spider-Man 2, Arcade, where I imagine you just shoot webs into the thin air, and Hybrid, which is said to combine the best of both worlds and is the closest thing to the swinging from the last title. Number 1. It's staying single player only. This may either come as good news or as a disappointment depending on your outlook towards the industry these days, but it looks as though Spider-Man 2 will remain an exclusively single player experience. Personally, I'd kind of hope for some sort of co-op mode. There's clear potential for one to work, but if Insomniac feel more comfortable putting their resources into crafting the best single player story they can, then more power to them. I'm sure it's going to be something mighty impressive.